Imagine for a moment your entire job site and project could be represented as a single panel of dials and switches. If you're a project manager looking to turn that one dial to improve your team's performance, we suggest you look at this one. Greetings and welcome to this week's Prime Insight. If you're a project manager or site foreman, here's an important question you should find out if you don't already know. What generation of abrasive metering valve do you have on your blast pots? It may surprise you that this valve is one of the most significant indicators of your efficiency and profit. This is one of the most important yet neglected considerations of the majority of job sites that we visit. Now, we won't attempt to make you a valve expert in this Prime Insight, but it's to your financial advantage to understand the metering valve that you're using and why it's most likely costing you hundreds of dollars a day in inefficiencies. First, here's a general layout of the abrasive metering valves currently in use. These are listed from least efficient to the most efficient across a broad range of blasting applications. So, what makes one metering valve better than another? One metric: which valve saves you the most money? And this metric should be evaluated on the following four criteria: wasted abrasive, cleanup costs, productivity and downtime, and the needed repairs or replacement parts. We've explained these costs in a previous Prime Insight, and we'll offer that link at the end of this video. But suffice it to say, thousands of dollars can be lost each day simply by saving $200 on a cheap metering valve. Now, this is something that every project manager should pay attention to. A popular misunderstanding is that all these valves represent different methods of metering, and that's not correct. Each column is actually a generational improvement on previous valves. So think of it this way. The engineering and materials have improved with each product upgrade. The metering has got more precise, conserving abrasive. Breakdowns and repairs have drastically reduced with each generation. Now, as we've presented things, you may seem that the silver bullet to everyone's problems is simply to buy this most current valve, the Axiom Schmidt Terra valve. And it probably is our top recommendation. It not only improves efficiency across the broadest range of industrial applications, but surprisingly, it also costs less than its previous predecessor, the Thompson 2 valve. However, for those high flow job sites, multiple number 10 nozzles, or in a blast room situation using a robot, the Thompson 2 is still our top recommendation. Now, in case you think that we're trying to sell you the more expensive valve, here's the insight within an insight. Because we're a business just like you, striving day in, day out to make a profit on what we do, we've installed over 200 Terra valves on our vast rental fleet. You can imagine that renting blast pots comes with quite a bit of maintenance and the repair when they're returned. We've discovered that by simply installing Terra valves on our rental pots, those maintenance costs have dropped by 75%. That's why we recommend them. They are a superior product. In case you're interested, this link leads to a Terra valve retrofit kit so you can upgrade your current pot to the latest and greatest generation of metering valves. There's one more point to address, but first, if you'd like to watch the Prime Insight that addresses inefficiency cost, here's that link. If you have questions as to which valve is best for your pot and the applications, just reach out and ask. That's our job. Thank you for watching this week's Prime Insight. We'll see you next week.